So we're going to give that a little space because it's going to get, it's going to take up about that big an area.
When you think about it, there is an obvious connection between people and plants.
Okay, we can plant that one right in the center.
Plants are represented in our food, our clothes, our homes, our medicines, and even the air we breathe. But this story is about what many believe is a deeper connection.
I think we're just hardwired deep down in our DNA to have an appreciation for being out in the natural world and being surrounded by it. And there's something about that color green and knowing that photosynthesis is happening all around you that just makes you feel better. And to see things grow and to have a hand in it, is good for the spirit and good for the soul.
So what we're going to do is break those roots up a little bit. We're going to tease the roots out.
That connection forms the foundation for horticultural therapy, which uses plants and gardening to help treat a variety of mental and physical illnesses and improve health and wellness.
So we see the basic services like, basic medication management, therapy. Those are able to control symptoms. They can really help with reducing symptoms, getting people clinically stable. However, programs like horticulture therapy and other complementary services, they just bring them back to life, is the way we see it. Their mood is improved, their social functioning improves, you see them smile more, you see people enjoying life. And that is kind of hard to do just with medications alone.
The program is a joint effort between the North Carolina Botanical Garden and the University of North Carolina Medical Center's Center for Excellence in Community Mental Health.
Well, when I see it in my fingernails, I am definitely a better person. You feel accomplished, you feel connected, you feel that you've been a part of something bigger than yourself. You're part of everything that is, and without that, I think we're a little lost.
UNC's horticultural therapy program is the longest in the Southeast. It is one of the longest in the nation, and it builds on a long history of medical evidence showing that when social science, plant science, and medical science is combined, people's health is improved when they interact with living things.
Is that too deep though?
But horticultural therapy is very non-judgmental. And you're working with a living system, you're working with another living system. And to see that living system progress from a seed to a plant and then to harvest, then there's a connection that individuals can get with the environment, with the land, and with themselves too. So it works sort of a symbiotic relationship. There's an interdependence that is developed between people and the plants. I see people here that are very invested in what they've been doing here.
I'd like to see the plants grow into something that you can use. It's relaxing, it's fun to get out in nature, dig in the dirt.
Physicians must recommend their patients for the program. An assessment team determines eligibility and a treatment regimen. Trained therapists work with patients. A typical session involves a morning meeting before heading out to the garden.
I can say that at the beginning, when we came in and started working together, there was a reticence to talk or just, there's a lot of social stigma with people with mental illness. So there's often a fear of exposure. So now we come into the group and so how are our plants doing? Oh yeah, I can see that there's a big change between last week and this week. There's a feeling of hope that comes from watching a plant grow.
I think it is. It's very therapeutic.
Doctors say preliminary results for patient treatment are encouraging.
We are seeing mood improvement in people. We are seeing just self-rating from our clients showing that they feel good about themselves, reduced sort of need to have more frequent contacts with therapists for their illness.
Medical insurance does not cover the program's cost. For now, a variety of grants are paying for treatments while researchers study the therapy's long-term effectiveness.
And sometimes it takes more than words to take a person to a changing place, to find themselves understanding who they are and where they want to go. And sometimes that's plants and nature. I think for many people it is that. The gardening really does change lives for many people. We see that happening over and over again.